Students, now we'll discuss about another type of simple fruits or true fruits or aggregate fruits. And usually aggregate fruits get develops from multicarpellary apocarpous gynoecium. Multicarpellary apocarpous gynoecium or apocarpous ovary. Apocarpous ovary means all the carpels are free. And each carpel develops into a fleshy organ, and that is known as fruitlet. It means in aggregate fruits, all the fruits are divided into fruitlets. And group of fruitlets are known as itarium. In aggregate fruits also one flower develops into one fruit. But fruits develop from multicarpellary apocarpous ovary. Each carpel develops into fruitlet, and a bunch of fruitlets is known as itarium. They are also different types, but no need to discuss. And one type is itarium of berries. Itarium of berry means group of aggregation of berries is known as itarium of berry. And best example is custard apple. Custard apple. The second one is itarium of drupes. Group of drupes is known as itarium of drupes, and example is raspberry. So these are the different types of aggregate fruits. Next, the last type of true fruits are composite fruits. Composite fruits are also called multiple fruits. Composite or multiple fruits. They are multiple fruits. So composite or multiple fruits, they develops from whole inflorescence. Inflorescence means group of flowers. It is the arrangement of flowers. If all the flowers modified into a single fruit, then they are called composite fruits or multiple fruits. There are also again two different types. First one is sorosis. In this type, entire catkin inflorescence or spike inflorescence. Entire catkin or spike inflorescence modified into a fruit. Example, mulberry. If entire spike inflorescence modified into fruit, then it is for pineapple. And second type is cyconus. In this type, entire hypanthodium inflorescence, it is a special inflorescence. Hypanthodium inflorescence modified into fruit, and the best example is fig. These are the two types of composite and multiple fruits. So from this topic, the fruit, one of the important reproductive organ, that is totally completed. And another and a final reproductive organ of angiospermic flower, that is seed. Seed is the ultimate source for fertilization, and seed has two generations because it comes from the first parent and it germinate to give us another generations. That's why seed incorporated or two generations are incorporated in seed. And what is seed? Biologically it is known as ripened ovule. After fertilization, ovule transferred into seed. And this seed has two parts. The outer part of seed is known as seed coat, and inner part is ovule. The seed has two parts. Seed coat, the outer part of seed is known as seed coat, and the inner portion is known as ovule. And this is seed coat. And this seed coat has a scar, and this scar is known as hilum. And below the scar, there is a spore, and this spore is known as micropyle. And micropyle, it helps in exchange of oxygen and water for germination. During the favorable conditions, seeds germinate to produce new offsprings. For germination, oxygen and water, Oxygen and water both are very essential. That's why the exchange of water and oxygen, it takes place through micropyle. So micropyle helps in exchange of water and oxygen for germination of seed. And this seed coat, the seed coat again has two layers, outer and inner. The outer layer of seed coat is known as testa, and inner layer is known as tegmen. Seed, ripened ovule, it has two parts, seed coat and embryo. And seed coat again further classified into two layers, outer testa and inner tegmen. And the seed has a small scap. There is a small scap that is known as hilum. Below the scap, there is a small opening, and this opening is known as micropyle. Micropyle helps in exchange of oxygen or entry of oxygen and water for germination of seed. And the second part of seed is embryo. So embryo again, it has embryonal axis and cotyledons. The embryo has axis and cotyledons. So cotyledons are the reserve, they store the reserve food. And the axis of embryo, for example, this is the axis of embryo. The axis of embryo is known as tigellum, or it is also known as embryonal axis. And it has cotyledons, these are the cotyledons. If embryo has two cotyledons like that, then the seed is known as dicot seed or dicot embryo. If it has only one embryo, so one cotyledon, then the seed is known as monocot seed. This already I told you, angiosperms are classified into two types, dicots and monocots. That is mainly depends on number of cotyledons. Dicot seed, example pea, mango, custard, all this. Monocot seeds, rice, wheat, maize, and all these, all grains, usually grains or cereals, belongs to monocots, and remaining all this belongs to dicots. And depending on number of cotyledons, the seed is divided into two types, or embryo, because embryo is also part of seed. The seed is depending on number of cotyledons, seeds are two types, dicot seed and monocot seed. Now we'll see structure of dicots. The dicot seed, some examples for dicot seed: pea, castor, beans, all etc. And it has embryonal axis. This is the embryonal axis. The embryonal axis is called tigel, and it has two cotyledons. This is the upper part of embryonal axis. The upper part of embryonal axis is known as limule. The lower part is known as radicle. The axis of embryo has two parts, outer and inner. Outer part is known as plumule, and inner part is known as radicle. Where this plumule attaches with cotyledons, this portion is known as epicotyle. Where radicle attaches with cotyledons, and this portion is known as hypocotyle. And these are the two cotyledons present. Due to presence of two cotyledons, it is called di, means two. Two cotyledons, hence it is known as dicots. And after germination, this embryo present inside the cell. So after germination, the plumule portion of embryo, it is transferred into shoot system. Plumule of embryo is transferred into shoot system, and radicle develops into root system. In root topic, already I told you, the primary root is all, it is the elongation of radicle, and shoot system is developed from plumule. So plumule and radicle, they are the parts of axis of embryo. That is also called tigellum. After fertilization, plumule transferred into shoot system and radicle transferred into root system. And the cotyledons, usually they store the food material, and they are totally consumed. After that, the shoot system produces leaves, and leaves make the food material through the process of photosynthesis. This is the structure of dicots. Then, structure of monocot seed. Structure of monocot seed. In monocot, there is single cotyledon. And examples for monocot seed, best examples, rice, wheat, maize, etc. If you observe the structure of monocot seed, if you observe the structure of monocot seed, there is different parts are there. This portion is known as endosperm. Endosperm is a product of double fertilization, and this portion is known as alluron layer. It is a protein-rich layer which separates both endosperm and embryo. And this is embryo. There is only one cotyledon, and this cotyledon, it is a shield shape. It is large shield shaped cotyledon. It is also known as scutellum. This is also known as scutellum, and this is the axis. This is the embryonal axis. This is cotyledon. Only one cotyledon present, and this portion is known as lemule. The upper part of embryonal axis, lemule, and lower part is known as radicle. And lemule is protected by a protective layer, coleoptile, and it is radicle is protected by coleorhiza. It is the structure of monocot seed, and in monocot seed, the amount of endosperm remains with seed, hence monocot seed is also called endospermic seed. But in dicot, this endosperm is totally consumed, hence dicot seed is known as non-endospermic. Dicot seed is known as non-endospermic because endosperm is totally consumed. In case of monocot seed, the small amount of endosperm remains with seed, hence their monocot seed is also called endospermic seed. And there is large shield shaped cotyledon is known as scutellum. And both endosperm and embryo are separated by a protein rich layer. And this protein rich layer is known as alluron layer. And axis of embryo has two parts, plumule and radicle. Both plumule and radicle, they are protected by coleoptile and coleorhiza respectively. After germination, same plumule transferred into shoot system and radicle transferred into root system. These are the two different types of seeds, both dicot and monocot seeds. So from this topic, the different organs of angiospermic plant is totally completed. And one more topic of morphology is left that will be discussed in next video.